Good morning, guys. So last night I was able to get the rest of my supplies to finish the countertops that I've been waiting for. I ran out of polyurethane, it's polycrylic because it's water-based. I ran out of it, but yesterday I was able to get some. So it was supposed to be delivered yesterday. However, they did not deliver it, and they said that it would come next month, an entire month, and I've already waited on it for like 3 weeks. So I canceled that order, and I went to the store and got something comparable to what I ordered online. It wasn't in the store, unfortunately. It was supposed to be good stuff, but I can't see myself waiting for Amazon for 2 months for something to come in, because that's just too long. So I've already sanded this down. It did have some rough spots on it just from the application of the roller. So I sanded it with this. It's very rough 120 paper. This is for my mouse. I ordered some extra pads for this because I'm going to be sanding a lot of stuff soon. So it just has like a little roughness from the roller. You can see it actually. Yeah, be glad to use my sink again. The only thing I'm worried about right now, I'm not worried about scratching. This is good to go. What I'm worried about is water seeping under it. So I am going to focus around that area so water doesn't seep under it, and then you'd be able to peel the entire thing off. So I'm going to put all of this on my other channel, Fully Cooked. And I'll probably do a blog post on fullyliving.com about how I did this countertop, just to simplify it. I mean, I've showed you, like an entire vlog, I showed you me painting it, but it's really simple, and I want to share that in more detailed steps. So I decided to use a paint pad that I can roll along instead of roller, which gets partial coverage. This should get all coverage. Just going to dip the front of the pad in and smooth it out. I'm cleaning my supplies. I used a ladle actually, so you'll see what I did with that. But yeah, this worked pretty well. It isn't dry yet, so I don't know how exactly it's going to turn out, but I think it's good. The kids' room is done, except for just a little bit of cleaning and straightening up. I organized it. The closet is having a makeover, and that will as well be a blog post and a video on Fully Cooked. Right now, I'm still working on Fully Cooked and Fully Living, or Fully Cooked and Fully Fun, Raphael's channel. I have a bunch of videos that I still need to edit and put up, so keep on the lookout for that. I've been uploading my IKEA videos. Meow. I love cats. This is Raphael's, and Abigail helped. I'm sure she put all of these little things here because she has always drawn circles. Always, always, always. So I'm sure she drew a bunch of those and filled it in. It looks pretty good. My kids can actually play with their stuff now because I have it organized in here. Koala. We're learning to say our L's.
Koala.
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 And llama.
Llama.
Yes. And girl.
Girl.
Yes. And Israel.
And Israel.
Very good.
Hey guys, I have been working all day.
I got a comment not too long ago that said, I would trust you to paint in a wedding dress. Thank you so much. I have the patience of Job, I think. You sneaking? So I'm painting my countertop over there. I was going to put a marble print on it, you know, not a print, but a faux marble paint. And I decided against that. If you can tell how much my floor is moving just by Abigail moving. So I'm also going to paint this floor, but not now, but I am. We have all of our dirty dishes on this table right here because we can't use our sink yet because this is curing for another 2 or 3 days. I just put the last, very last coat that I'm ever going to put on it.
Did it come off?
And I can actually see that a little hand touched it before it was cured. I see some fingerprints there. I see fingerprints!
When you touch it, it doesn't come off.
No, but don't touch it because I don't want you to. Mm-hmm. So this had a really bad texture on it, but now it is pretty sheen all over. And it was because of the polyurethane that I was using was not the right one, I don't think. I'll show you what I was using. It's pretty upsetting because I wasted a lot of time. I got this for a project. I got to paint this door right here too. Anyway, I used this one. One coat polyurethane. You know when it says one coat, it's a liar. I put like 6 coats on it with this. And it never, like, it was never hard enough. It says three times protection in one coat. It was never hard enough. It never hardened. So what I had to do was get regular, not regular polyurethane, but the... Let me show you. See this? Oh, look at all my materials. See this? It's polycrylic. But you want it in the, you know, the gallon or whatever. So many things. Minwax. Water-based, so it's not oil and it's not hard to clean up and it doesn't take forever to dry. Polycrylic protective finish. Clear satin. This is what I had to use in the first place. And the way I was applying it was not correct either because I was trying to roll it on and it was getting like this... It would be smooth and then it would be rough and smooth and rough, like all down one strip. It was just really not good. I got a pad, just a square pad to do it with. And now it's a uniform finish. And it looks like it was made that way. And I love it. So you can see the sheen on it from the light. I keep saying sheen. It reminds me of Sheena. You can see the sheen. It looks really good. I like it. It's really good. But you can also see that my house is tore up. I still have yet to put up my stuff from IKEA because, yeah, I gotta hang up my clothes. I mean, stuff's tore up here, but I have the kids' room done and I'm fixing to do a blog post and a video on that. Blog post on fullyliving.com and a video on Fully Cooked. I have lots of videos on Fully Cooked coming up, lots. And I'm gonna show a bunch of stuff making over the house without spending the thousands of dollars. Somebody said, oh, you're spending a lot of money on that. I barely spent any money on this. I did have to buy a gallon of polyurethane because I'm going to do the floors as well and I wanna protect that. And that was expensive. The stain that I used on this was free. I already had it, so, and I didn't hardly use any of it. I thought I would have to buy another, because I had a little can. I thought I would have to buy a whole nother can. And I didn't. I didn't even use the what I had left of that. So that's going to last me for a while. I know I'm talking about this a lot, but it's like literally consuming my life until it's done, I guess. But I am done with the kids' room, and that was a big project for me. So finally, I'm done with that. She's starting a timer. What are you timing? Okie dokie. So I am painting this over here. Now we've been toying with the idea of painting the bottom cabinets a different color, but honestly I think it would be a little too much to have wood cabinet here, white countertop there with a different color there. And so actually now that I'm looking at it, I'm probably not going to do that. But yeah, it's pretty much consuming our life. This table's gonna leave and it's gonna open up our space here. And after I'm done with the countertops, I am going to finish the bottom of the counters, the cabinets. I'm going to redo the finish on that because they are just really nasty. And then I'm going to start in the bathroom, and I'm going to do the floor in the bathroom and the hallway. I don't know if I'm going to do it at the same time, but I probably should. So that's not going to be able to be used for like 3 days. That's going to be hard. We're going to have to take, showers at my mom's house or something. And then I'm going to do the kitchen floor sometime after that. It's going to be a while because I want to have a break where I can use something and not be in a construction zone. But that's basically what my life has ended up being for the past couple weeks. Okay, honestly decided I'm too tired to finish tonight. I am done with the counter though, so tomorrow I can start putting the polyurethane on, which is great. However, I was going to start on the bathroom floor tonight and just wipe it out, get it done. I'm going to do it tomorrow. I'm going to do the bathroom and the hallway here, which is kind of connected, but there's four different types of floor that I can see right now. So I have this floor, which we absolutely hate because it's really low quality and it's wet and damaged. And then I have this floor, which is a good quality. I mean, it's good. It's linoleum. And then we have this floor, and I hate it very much. It's very glossy and don't like it. And then we got this floor, which is all right. I don't hate it. So this floor will be white and this floor will be white. And then we got the brownish rug that's going to stay here. Brown and white rug. I just bought that. It's got a bunch of stuff on it now. And I don't think I'm touching this yet. Yet. But yeah, I want to. I had Hadar empty out the bathroom so I could paint the floor.
Hey guys.
Hi. Oh, hair is your worst enemy when you're painting a floor. I'll tell you that much.
Looking.
And if you're a shedder, that's really bad.
Good. First coat?
This is the first coat of the bonding paint, so it's not going to look good. But this is what it's going to look like. It's going to be white. In here, it's going to be white. In the hallway, it's going to be white. But in the kitchen, I've decided to do white with a gray streak. Do I have sweat on me? With gray streaks to make it look like whitewashed gray wood. I am so tired right now. Like, I am asleep sitting up, honestly. Hadar can attest.
You're doing a good job, though.
But here it is. I'm totally done with this first coat. And look at my leg. When you have EDS, you bruise super easy and you have no idea what happened. So goodbye. The next well checkup's gonna be for the animals, but today we're taking the kids. We'll have to wait out in the car this time, go in one at a time.
Abigail always likes to dip her chips into her applesauce.
It's gorgeous. Somebody spent a lot of time hand making this, and I appreciate this.